Yo-Yo, here we are on the occasion of your upcoming release. This is the third time you have recorded these six suites for solo cello by Bach. You recorded them in your 20s, you revisited them in your 40s. Here you are almost 20 years later. I mean, you are known for your incredible curiosity. You play music from 400 years ago and you play music that was written for you yesterday. But you're spending a lot of time with this music in a really deep way. Why take on this music now?
A lot changes between 20 and 40. And now that I'm 62, in the remaining time I have, I'm kind of assessing sort of like, well, what do I know? What is it that I can offer that's different from what I was trying to do 20 years ago? You know, sometimes we read a book when we're 12. And then when we reread it, when we're 30, it's a different book. As a performer, I exist to do something hopefully useful. Look, I found a certain truth with the cello, and this is it. That's the gift that I can bring because I've been doing it for 55 years. But I want to do it in a way that is actually accessible to everybody in the community. There's something about this music that actually makes things whole. And I'm grateful to Bach for being the scientist composer that he was, and like Shakespeare, to take all of what he knew about human nature and say, here it is, tragedy, comedy, joy, sorrow, and presenting it to us, the completion part is, to me, the secret of the Bach cello suites. He knows the instrument. He wants the instrument to do more. Now, the actual genius part, it says, I'm going to make the listener's ear subconsciously, implicitly work to fill in the gaps. That, to me, is the secret of why people feel when they're in need, they are being helped. It's because subconsciously he is eliciting action from the listener's part to complete.
You have a project going on where you're going to really concentrate on the performance of this music as a force in the world for good. What can we expect from you for the next 2 years?
I want to meet audiences and find out what they're doing, what they're thinking. I'm always thinking about what is it that we can do together that we can't do alone. And I think that together we are so much more powerful in being able to deal with intractable challenges. Going to 36 places, and so whether you go to borders, or inner cities, or places where industry has left, and where the people are feeling, we're trying, but nobody's listening. Well, we want to go and listen. Recognize who they are as individuals, as real participants in society. This music is just a little gift to try and start these conversations. And so the day after the concert will be a day of action. I think culture can do everything to dispel fear, because fear makes us smaller. Culture makes us larger, and that's what we need.